Apart from yourself, what do you want to compare today? In this video, we'll take a look at some of the common use cases where you would need to compare various elements in your code base and see how IntelliJ IDEA can help. We'll cover comparing our project files, such as source code, configuration settings, CSV files, packages, or directories. In a similar way, we could also compare our project files with non-project files. Comparing the text copied to your clipboard with a file, comparing revisions in the local history, comparing a file across branches when you're working with a version control system, and the last one is using git blame annotations to identify the person who modified a line, including the modifications. Let's deep dive into comparing project files. You might have noticed source files in a code base that look similar but are not identical, such as the process student data and data processing classes. Let's compare these files to see all the differences between them. There are multiple ways to do so. Select these files in the project window, right-click and choose Compare Files. The second way is to use the shortcut Ctrl and D after selecting the files in the project window. You can also use Find Action, Search Everywhere, or use the main menu View and then choose Compare Files. IntelliJ IDEA will open a built-in diff viewer that allows you to clearly see all of the differences between the files. On the top right, you can view the count of differences. On the top left, you can use the arrows or their corresponding shortcuts to move through the differences. The default settings is to view the differences side by side. You can modify and change it to a unified viewer if you prefer that. Another default setting is not to ignore white spaces, empty lines, imports, or formatting. Again, this is configurable. You can also choose how to view the differences. Do you want to highlight lines, words, characters, or you want to choose from other options? The settings offers other customizations such as hiding or displaying the line numbers. I usually prefer to view the line numbers. You can also swap the sides of your files using this icon. You can use the diff viewer to accept changes from one file to another. If I click here on this double arrow, I accept addition of this import statement to the file on the left. This feature is quite helpful for comparing longer files, such as the configuration files. This week I created and exported two inspection profiles, Migrate to Java 11 and Migrate to Java 21. To find the inspections that were disabled in the Java 11 inspection profile, let's compare these files to find out the difference. These are really long files, so I could use these arrows here to fold the code that is same across these files. This makes it easy to view just the differences in one glance. As expected, Migrate to Java 11 inspection profile disables inspections which are specific for text blocks, one of the user-defined inspections that I excluded, pattern variables and patterns, switch and record. Comparing long CSV files using this feature is such a relief. And that is not all. You can also compare directories using this feature and compare them for files and their contents. You could also use this feature to compare more than two files, though the result might look cluttered. Until now, I talked about the files that were all defined in the same project. You can also use this feature to compare your project files with non-project files. That is the files that are defined outside of your project. But why would you want to do so? One of the situations could be when you want to compare the properties of your application with the properties of another application. In this case, select the configuration file in the project tool window and choose action Compare With, pointing to the configuration file you want to compare your file with. I know that's really a tongue twister. This comparison displays the same diff window that we have seen with our previous comparisons. It has the same controls for you to navigate the differences and act on them. What if you want to compare the content of one of your files with the code that you copied to your clipboard? Is that possible? Yes, it is. And you do not need to create a new or a temporary file to do so. First of all, copy the code to your clipboard. Now open your file in the editor and select the action Compare with Clipboard, either by right-clicking the file in the editor or by using Find action or Search everywhere. The diff viewer would show all the differences to you. You can compare sections of your code, which is quite interesting. Let's copy code for just one method to our clipboard, and in the editor, select just one section of a file and invoke Compare with Clipboard. This could be quite helpful to limit the code that you want to compare. With this feature, you can also compare and track the changes recorded by your local history and roll back specific modifications. There are multiple ways to go about it. In the project window, select the file name, right-click to invoke its context menu. Choose local history and then show history. In the diff view that shows the results, you can use these icons to roll back modifications. It is also possible to compare and track the changes recorded by local history for a section of your file. Select the code in the editor, right-click to invoke context action, and instead of selecting Show History, select Show History for selection. You'll see the results that are limited to your selected code. If your project is under version control, you'll find this feature quite useful. It allows you to compare a file in your current branch with the same file in another branch. And sometimes this is much faster and more convenient than browsing the file's history. In the Project Tool window, right-click a file. Since I'm using Git, I can view and select Git here, followed by the option Compare with Branch. And now let me select this as the branch for comparison. In the diff viewer, I can view the changes and roll back if required. Annotate with Git Blame. You can use this option to identify the last person who modified a line and see what the modification was. In the editor, right-click the gutter and select Annotate with Git Blame. Hover your mouse over an annotation to view the modifications right in the editor. The last topic in this video is about opening a blank diff viewer and comparing any sort of text. Use Find action and search for Open Blank Diff Window. In the tab that opens, paste two versions of any piece of code or text to see how they differ. In this video, I covered the options you have for comparing various elements in IntelliJ IDEA. We started with comparing project files like source code, configuration files, CSV files, and folders. Similarly, we can compare all other project files with non-project files, that is files from other projects or locations. We also saw examples of comparing files with clipboard, revisions in the local history, and VCS branches. Comment and let me know about your feedback on this video. Thanks for watching.